I got in a room with another lovely English individual, Sasha Skarbek, and Maureen MacDonald, also known as Mozella. And we didn't know each other. And this was 2012, September 24th. Don't ask me why I remember that date. We got together in a Suzuki sort of studio in West LA. And Mozella, and I think it's safe to say that she shares a story, but she was about to get married that particular week. And we had just all met, and she decided to call off the wedding. And she was brave, and there was this courage to her. And she even really didn't have she didn't really want to come to the session that day. But, we didn't know each other. She was just, devastating week for her. She just was in a sort of toxic relationship, as I think a lot of us can relate to at some point or another. It was just mentally toxic, if that makes any sense. And she just thought that just she'd be making the biggest mistake of her life had she pursued this wedding and gone through with it. And she was very emotional. And Sasha and I were there consoling her throughout the time. And the reason why this is such a important part of the story is that she certainly was these, when you listened, we clawed, we could, our hearts in vain, we jumped, never asking why. I mean, those lines came from Mozella. They came from her heart. They came from a real place of darkness and sadness and, and her relationship. She crafted that lyric so beautifully. And we all sort of crafted this song together. And we just kind of like, we literally wrote this song in an afternoon, in a few hours. And the beauty, Sasha is also a wonderful, wonderful pianist here from London. But for some reason, he happened to be in Los Angeles at that time. I was living in Canada. I had flown up to LA to write with these two. And our publishers put us together that day. They wanted us to write a song for Beyonce. But a lot of people don't realize when you put a bunch of songwriters who don't know each other, and this happens a lot in the songwriting world, into a room, you just kind of, if you have the good ones, the great writers, you just kind of roll with it. It's just an instinctive thing. I mean, it's great to have a raison d'être, a goal to write for, but we kind of flowed with it that day, not knowing who the song, we just wanted to write a great song. So, do you want me to perform a bit of it? I mean, just kind of show you the sort of the genesis of the song and how beautiful it can be at the piano as well, because in a lot of ways it really is a classical piece of music, and it was produced in a kind of rock pop way. But here's Wrecking Ball at the piano. But to conclude that story and to wrap it up, we had written that song in that day. It kind of came through us all. And then I remember at the end of the session, Mozella asking us, we all can kind of concur that we weren't too sure if it was Beyonce would be the right artist for it, as much as great as Beyonce is. Mozella said, I think I'm going to be seeing or speaking with Miley in the next few weeks. Do you guys mind if I, like, give the song to Miley? And Sasha's like, sure, great. And then everything just lined up, like, just like a beautiful, beautiful explosion, right? I mean, there was Miley and her relationship all public, and, you know, and Miley being vulnerable to the world at that time in 2013 with a very great and provocative video by Terry Richardson. It was just the perfect storm.